Hello, 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 hello. Welcome you all to another episode of Coffee Not Tea. I am your host, Miss K Legacy on the internet. And you guys, it's just some stuff going on. You know what I mean? So we're just gonna jump right into it. You know, I like to go straight to the news. I feel like I'm looking a little bright today. It's throwing me off. So, you know, everybody has a different type of day with their makeup. So just pardon me. All right, so I wanna get started with, let's get started with Judge Esther Salas. So, I'm sure you all have already heard as of yesterday, this is breaking news that the husband of Judge Esther Salas was shot. He was critically wounded and her son was murdered last night. And if you all don't know who Judge Haishay, if you all don't know who Judge Esther Salas is, she is the judge presiding over Jeffrey Epstein's case. So that's why her being attacked and her son being murdered. Oh, and then here's the kicker. So the suspect, what's his name? He was an attorney. Okay, here it is. Let me just read it. Okay, a self-described anti-feminist attorney who killed himself is the primary suspect in the fatal shooting of the son of a New Jersey federal judge, U.S. investigators say. The attorney, Roy Dan Hollander, was found dead Monday after a Federal Bureau investigation led manhunt to find the shooter responsible for the killing of Daniel Andrew, the son of this judge, okay? So, the man who is a suspect in the murder, the man who's a suspect in the murder has committed suicide. So he's killed himself, and of course we all are aware of the Pizzagate conspiracy and all this stuff going on with Ghislaine Maxwell being arrested. You know, there were some issues with her prosecutor. Her prosecutor actually did not want to press charges. So Trump actually made him step down and appointed another prosecutor so that Ghislaine would actually be charged and she couldn't leave jail. So the first prosecutor wasn't even trying to put her in jail. So there is a lot of money, there's a lot of allegiance, and there's just like a lot of deep-rooted corruptness that's going on right now. So the fact that this judge was attacked, okay, and the fact that now her husband is in critical condition and her son is now dead, and she is the judge over the Epstein case, it's just like raising eyebrows is an understatement, because it's just like, is this like conspiracy playing out in our face? Like, it's almost like conspiracy isn't conspiracy anymore. You know what I'm saying? Like, what, like, that's like evident. You know what I mean? That something's being covered up. So, of course, y'all know that we're just gonna have to follow the story and we're just gonna have to find out, because, guys, something's not right. You know what I mean? So, if y'all want to look up more about Judge Esther Salas, I got this article from the Washington, I always say the Washington, the Wall Street Journal, okay? So, yeah, guys, we're just going to have to wait, but, like, Pizzagate is, like, scared, you know? Like, that's crazy. Let's talk about Kanye. Y'all, so, did y'all watch it? Like, I actually watched his rally. So, of course, the media, they're always gonna like try to twist things. And yes, Kanye is radical, okay? So, of course, he was off the wall. But you guys, like when you watch the whole thing, like the stuff that he was talking about, this is like the whole Harriet Tubman thing. I definitely feel like he could have been a little bit more explanatory with what he was saying. But I feel like he was saying, like, essentially, it was about black ownership. That's why he said she never freed the slaves, because she kind of just took them from slavery to go work for somebody else. Now, of course, slavery and working for money were contrastly different, but I think that he was alluding to, and I think this is where Kanye always messes up. He just like, you know, says things that are explosive, but then they're vague because he doesn't really give, you know, a well-rounded explanation for the things that he's saying. So when he said it was to speak to black ownership, you know, because we still are essentially working for others and we lack ownership. So I believe that that's what he was saying. But when I watched the full rally, of course, I don't think that he's going to really, you know, he's not going to win the presidency. But, you know, the points that he was making, he's a pro-lifer. And he was talking about when the articles talk about how he was crying because, you know, he had got emotional. People were, you know, the blogs were saying that it was a chaotic rally and that it was bizarre. But, you know, he started crying when he was talking about abortion because he wanted to abort North. And he got emotional because he knew that he almost, you know, killed his daughter. And that's probably what you're seeing floating around. Like, hey, y'all, my dryer's going off. But that's probably what you're seeing floating around when it's just like, oh, you know, it's bizarre and he's doing this, then a third. But he was feeling guilty about knowing that he was going to abort North. So he was overcome with emotion because he started to reflect on his own life because his father wanted to abort him. And that's where you see him kind of, you know, where he has his breakdown and he's just like, you know, just passionate about pro-life. Overall, the rally, you know, Kanye's saved now. He talks about, you know, he tries to minister and this, that, and the third. And I'm not going to judge him. But, you know, listening to him, I just use the spirit of discernment. And, you know, I think that he still kind of has like a long way to go, like us all. I just feel like Kanye's is radical, but his message was not as off the wall as the media was trying to make it. Like, Kanye made some valid points and he really spoke some powerful words. So I suggest that you all probably go and look at the whole rally if you haven't already, because you know, he did all right. I did kind of get a little bored near the end of it because it just sounded like he was, you know, talking a lot, and it was kind of hard to follow. But like the first 30 minutes of it, you know, Kanye, he made sense, and I don't think that he's like crazy like these people trying to say. Okay, I'm not gonna be with y'all long tonight, just because there wasn't really much news. RIP, rest in peace, former Senator John Lewis. You know, we're just grateful for any leader that stood up for, you know, Black rights in that time frame when we were fighting for equality, when we were fighting for real equality, you know, not like what Black Lives Matter is doing right now. But, you know, we pay homage to those who really stood on the front lines for us during the civil rights movement, peacefully protesting, or, you know, just really a part of that change for us to live the lives that we're living today. So rest in peace, Senator John C. Lewis, and thank you for your service. And then lastly, yeah, this is gonna be a quick one, guys, because it's really not, you know, it's kind of been a little bland. Coronavirus, still kind of the same. Cases rising. Morbidity rate, still not astronomical. So they're still trying to reopen schools. That's still a thing. So, you know, it's not really much going on. But I do want to end it with this. I'm sure you all have probably heard of her now. Bevelyn, Beatty, and Edmee, Chavannes. These are two women who are saved. They're Jesus believers. And they were charged for painting over the Black Lives Matter mural in front of the Trump Tower in NYC. I'm sure y'all have seen her before. Do they have any pictures of her right here? No, I don't have any pictures of her. But I'm sure you all have seen Miss Bevelyn before. She was, she's also anti-abortion and she's a street preacher. I've seen her before. She's been circulating around social media, especially since these Black Lives Matter protests. She's like anti-Black Lives Matter. She knows that they're trying to dismantle the nuclear family. She knows that they don't care about, you know, Black men. She knows that, you know, they're really like a demonic organization. That's what she calls it, you know. Like, she was out there, she was like, we want our police. Y'all talking about y'all care about Black Lives Matter, y'all lying. Y'all don't care about us. She said, refund our police. Don't defund our police, refund our police. So she got arrested, but she said that her and this woman, Edmee, I believe that Edmee is her roommate or something like that, only because, you know, they're preaching the gospel. So I don't believe that they're in a, you know, a homosexual relationship. I just think that they are roommates, or probably close friends. But they talked about their experience with the police and when they were arrested, that the police like treated them like royalty, because, you know, the police are in a different type of situation right now. You know, you have the country kind of like split up, you know, people, some hate them, you know, and others, you know, support and love the police. So they're just kind of, you know, stuck between a rock and a hard place. So I know that it was encouraging for them to see somebody so brave who still supports the police really more than their own cities, their own mayors, you know. So I know that that was encouraging for our police force. I'm sorry. So Black Lives Matter aren't for us, no. No, 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 no. Girl, Black Lives Matter is a money laundering vehicle for the Democratic Party, girl. Where that money going? They're not putting it back into our communities. They didn't even get no money to the families of the children who were slain. Black Lives Matter, if you go on their, girl, go on their page. Go look at their mission. They want to dismantle cisgender privilege. And cisgender is just being born a natural man or a natural woman. Okay, that's what they're calling cisgender privilege. So we're really in a sad time in society where being born a man or a woman is considered privilege. But they talk about dismantling cisgender privilege and dismantling the nuclear family. So they don't want fathers in the homes. Girl, it's like, I gotta, girl, listen. I mean, listen, you know, you look, go and research it yourself, girl, because... And honestly, it always comes around, if you look at the trends, Black Lives Matter comes around every election year. This is like an election tool used by the Democratic Party, you know, to create, you know, problems and to kind of put this fake cape on, try to fix. It's really like war against Donald Trump. You know, they're trying to blame Trump for all of this when really it's a lot of hands in the pot. So, yeah, girl, just read about Black Lives Matter, girl. They don't support, like, you know, fathers in the home. They're not trying to do none of that. Like, you know, girl, just go read about what they're talking about on their page. Like, you know, so these two black women, they went and vandalized the mural. And they poured black paint. And she was like, y'all lying. Y'all don't care about us. You know, we won our police this, that, and the third. So, she actually is being called a hero right now. Of course, not by the people who are on the left, like I say. But, like, Bevelyn, Beatty, Edmee, Chavannes, like, they're on the right side of things, you know. Because Black Lives Matter is truly corrupt. It really, really is. And they don't care about us. Like, for real. You know, and that's why, speaking of, I don't have it with me. I'm going to cover it in an episode. But Detroit's violent. Did y'all see what's going on in Detroit this past weekend? I don't know if y'all saw that awful video that's trending. I couldn't even share it on my page because it's so awful. But it's a young man. I'm from Detroit. It's a young man in the Coney Island. And he just shoots. He shoots, like, three men, like, off rip, just, like, in the head. And, like, lays them out. It's circulating around Facebook. Be warned if you do see it. It's a gruesome video. But, like... I won't say black on black crime, but like crime, period, is like breaking records that have not been broken in 20 years this year. And it's because of all of this unrest, all of these riots, and, you know, pretty much with Black Lives Matter, defund the police, is that energy, that lawlessness, you know. And the more momentum it gains, like, the more violence, the more criminal activity, the more ungodliness, the more lawlessness, the more wickedness that we're going to be seeing manifested. Because, oh yeah, girl, and I'm not going to share it. I'm not going to share it on my page because it was like, wow, this is not a movie. Like, he point blank shot three young black men, all of them young. He point blank shot three of them right in the Coney Island. Boom, in the head, headshots. Like, girl. And this happened this past weekend. They talking about it, you can look it up. It's a shooting at Coney Island. I think it was like 17 shootings or something like that. Or like, what was it? Was it like 17 shootings in Detroit or something like that? And like, four or seven people are dead now. Like, crime is skyrocketing, like raising over 200% and 400% in different areas because of the unrest of this climate. So, like, yeah, girl, go check out Black Lives Matter. Pray about it, because it's definitely not an organization that's trying to unify. Not at all. Like, it's all about dismantling the American system. It's all about, you know, making you feel not proud to be American when we're the best. We are the greatest country on the planet Earth. People risk everything to come here and try to have the American dream. And, you know, the only way to destroy the best country is to destroy it from within. So these are people with really corrupt, you know, agendas, and they want new world order. And if you can weaken the country from the inside, or you can make the country weak, then we'll be able, like, we'll be in a state where they can implement socialism. And, like, BLM, a Marxist organization. Like, we just gotta look up what these words mean. But pretty much, like, control, you know, and really just like the annihilation of the American system. So, girl, it's going down. Like, it's just pretty much going down. So, we just gotta stay prayed up. We're gonna be seeing breaking news more and more. I'm excited for this election to kind of get wrapped up. And, you know, I'm ready for this year to be over because, you know, this has been like one of the most craziest election years that I think, well, of course, that I feel like I've ever lived through. And, you know, I'm just ready for this to be over. Oh, my thing about to go off again. I don't have anything else. I'm probably going to do an episode tomorrow. The news has been really quiet. Well, not really quiet, but, you know, not a lot of stuff is going on. You're informed, man. Oh, yeah, baby, of course. But, yeah, I'm about to go. I'm about to whip me up a steak, okay? And that's really all I got for y'all. Watch that Kanye West. Watch that rally. And just, like, watch the full rally. You can find it on YouTube and, you know, try to get through, like, the first 20 minutes of it and then just form your own opinion because the media is really trying to, you know, they're always trying to call Kanye crazy, but Kanye, you know, he said some powerful words. All right, so do I have anything else? I think I covered everything. All right, I love you guys with Jesus joy. I'll talk to y'all later. Bye.